Yeah, so the Cowboy Drummer name came about. So I'm not actually a cowboy. There's meaning behind it, so everyone's, you know, should understand. But basically what it was is my grandfather and my father both passed away, and my grandfather wore cowboy hats. Like, that was his thing. He was like a cowboy dude. And then my father was the drummer, and that's where I got like my drumming gift from. I eventually created the Cowboy Drummer. Like, I just was like, let me honor both of their names and just like live my father's dream. And they're both my men in my life that raised me, you know, so.
You know, your little skits and stuff like that, they've kind of really taken off over 2022 in particular. One of the highlights that I saw recently was when Eric Moore shared your stuff. And I think it was when you were dancing the shoe on the kick drum pedal or whatever. I was like, oh shit, Eric Moore.
A lot of people have like shared, like Tommy Lee shared one of mine one time. That was pretty fucking cool. Some rapper people, like this one rapper chick, I think she goes by Lotto now. She's like a Cardi B type chick.
Yeah.
She like shared some of my stuff. Yeah, I've had some cool like little, a bunch more too, man. I forget. A lot of cool people have followed me recently too. It's cool that, dude, even like when you shared my post, you were talking about like when you came across one of my posts and you shared it. I remember I followed you back too, because I remember I got a notification. It was like a page with over 10,000 followers shared your thing. And I was like, oh shit, that's cool. Like, this dude with like this big audience liked my video and shared it to his audience. Like, that was cool as hell of you.
If ever I see, I mean, my page is music only with a shit ton of humor and, you know, no bullshit, nothing that splits people apart. I'm just here to like try to bring people together, right? So any way that I can spread the love, dude, to people that are doing good things, I'm gonna try to do that at all costs. Sweet kindred drum spirits right now. Awesome.
Hell yeah. Hell yeah, dude. Absolutely, I love it.
You did a post a little while ago that you were kind of going through the list of things that you had been through in your life, at least at a high level early on, before you ended up where you are now. You know, trials, tribulations, you know, whatever you're willing to share about that. You know, you don't have to get too detailed at every single thing, but just kind of at a high level, you know, like what is your background with that stuff? I personally had, growing up, lots of trauma and shit like that, and lots of addiction in my family and stuff too. So I understand all of that sphere. You know, you've obviously done a lot of work on yourself to get focused in life and put something positive out there. And I was just curious, you know, kind of what your background was.
It's a bad thing. I got involved into drugs at a young age because I got my wisdom teeth pulled out from there all at the same time. And then they all got infected because I was already like fucking around, like smoking and doing like the doctors told me what to do. And I did the opposite kind of thing. So, you know what I mean? Yeah. Moral of that story, they loaded me up with all kinds of pills because I was and kept getting infected. And then after that, that's when I was 16. And then I just got bad addicted into drugs, man. I ended up getting into heroin eventually some years later. I ended up in jail. I was doing all kinds of scams. I got caught doing all kinds of bullshit. Eventually, after in and out of jail for like years, I got into a drug court program, and then I graduated that in 2013. Yeah, it's been 10 years, and I just stopped doing it and changed my whole life around. And
Was there a moment or a situation that kind of like pushed you to that point, or a bottoming out of sorts that happened? Or
dude, it was just going to jail so many times. Like, after like so many times, I remember just being in there one time, and then I was talking to the guy next to me, who I couldn't see. But we ended up talking. He's like from Virginia, and he was just like, dude, you're a good kid. What are you doing in here? Yeah, I don't know. I think I just got fed up, man. I just literally just stopped. I just decided to stop doing it, you know?
Yeah, totally. And now look where you are. It's pretty dope, dude.
Dude, and I was able to just, I'm so grateful, man. It's crazy to think about.
Anyway, you and I could talk about life shit for a really long time, I have a feeling. So
yeah, we could go down the rabbit hole, dude, for sure.
For sure. But I really appreciate you sharing all that stuff. I think that hearing that from, you know, other people being able to hear that other artists can like go through that, get out of it, and then just go stay positive the whole time, I think is awesome, dude. So good on you for that. Yeah, you had also, so I saw a post a little while ago, you were talking about some shoulder issues, and I've had my right shoulder, like my rotator cuff is like, it's the moodiest bitch in my entire body.
And remember,
I don't think it's torn, but it's like, it easily gets inflamed. And when I was in a band, I've been in bands my whole life until about 2015. And like the last few years of that, it's like you get to that point where like all of a sudden you just can't, I come down really hard on the china, on the quarter notes sometimes, on heavier parts of songs and shit. And I just couldn't like do it as much anymore. How have you been able to manage that while you've been on tour and stuff?
Yeah, getting shots. Yeah. Literally, yeah. Like I had to, dude, but you're right. Like I've gotten two in both arms now. but they lasted a year. So I got a shot in this one. They're like 6 months apart. I'm like staggered. Yeah, it's been working, but dude, I'm afraid because I've been trying to just work out a lot too and get stronger and do physical therapy. It sucks being a drummer, man. I've been doing the thing where I've been like playing my china like this. Totally. That's what I've been doing, man. Yeah.
Switching gears to the band now. So your band, Dropout Kings, are you guys all based out of the East Coast?
No, so the band is from Phoenix. Our bass player, now he switched to bass now because our bass player quit.
Got it.
So we moved him, but he's from Detroit, and then I'm from Rochester, and then the rest of the guys are from Phoenix. So we're a little spread out, but the band is based out of Arizona.
Oh, okay, that's cool. I mean, the beauty of nowadays, dude, is like you can totally just throw tracks around and build on them remotely until you're ready to get together and start like playing them and recording and shit and touring, you know? So,
dude, literally, that's what we do too. Yeah. With the band, we send each other shit all the time, new ideas, new beats and stuff. It's pretty cool. But then we'll eventually meet up and like, you know, like do the record or whatever.
Yeah, yeah. And then do all of you guys have, you know, jobs where they're flexible enough where it's like, you got to make some money while you're at home for whatever reason. If you need to duck out, like you can duck out, you know, and do the thing or what?
Yeah, like we all have, I mean, so like the band is really our main, like, so Adam does like marketing. Adam is our screamer.
Yeah.
He does like marketing and shit. So he's working with bands. Bill, our rapper, he does a lot of like just like musical art stuff. He sells his art. He does a couple other like things. I'm not really sure. he just does the band. Like Rob, he does some tattoos, so he can kind of just fuck off whenever he wants. And
yeah.
And then Stage, our guitar player, he just does the band. And then me, I just do the band and like my social media stuff.
Yeah. So, yeah, good.
We do well with the band to all sustain, you know, we eat, doing okay.
Dude, you can pay bills, eat, be your own boss and play music for a living. Like who's going to hate that? As far as the growth for Dropout Kings, once I started to see your stuff, I also started to just kind of generally with events and festivals and stuff that kind of float up into my feed. Was this last year? Was there a lot of growth for the band? Did you end up taking on some bigger shows and stuff or?
Yeah. Oh yeah. This last year was our biggest year for sure. We ended up hitting, we hit the highest numbers of all, we crossed 300,000 monthly listeners at one point. Yeah, dude, it was sick. We had so many cool, Louder Than Life. I played with Kiss. That was fucking sweet. We played with like Shinedown a few times.
Okay.
Guys, they're really cool. I don't know, it was a dope year for sure.
So for last question about the band, and then I have a pop quiz for you that's super short, but as far as 2023 is concerned, what are there some like key milestones you guys are trying to hit as a band as far as like where you're touring or what you're trying to get done?
We're going back to Europe and we're gonna hit even more countries that we didn't hit last time. And we're dropping our album on April 13th called Riot Music, which you can go to dropoutkingsmusic.com and you can see all that. But yeah, that's going to be like the milestone. I think when we release this album and some more singles and do music videos, we're projecting it to propel us to a pretty cool level. So, you know, set us up good for like later in the year and next year.
Nice.
But yeah, we're just going to bust our ass and tour a lot and hit as many festivals as possible. And we just did Shiprocked on that cruise ship. That was sick. That was a good way to start the year. So
yeah, I saw the footage of you guys totally sunburned and shit. I saw you on the
yeah, bottom. Dude.
Your neck and shoulders all lobstered.
Yeah, and then I was all white. I'm still all mismatched. Farmer's tan.
All right, pop quiz, and then I'll let you go and get back to your life here. So number sick. One, what's your hidden talent?
Hidden talent. Ooh, let's see. I can do this.
I can't do that. No.
Dude, that's what I'm saying. That's a talent. I don't think many people could do that.
I don't think many people can do that. I can go like this.
Yeah, I can't really do what.
So you actually default to your thing.
Yeah, like mine wants to do the clover thing. I actually play guitar too. That's actually another talent that not many people know, but I'm not like crazy good, but I can play. Like,
yeah,
I could be in like a cover band all day playing yeah. Chili Peppers. Shit, you know,
dude, most of the bands I've been in, most of the musicians I know, it's always the drummers that are usually the multi-instrumentalists. So
it always is.
No, the drummers are the best, just so you know. I'm just telling you. Yeah. Right,
we're smarter than everyone. That's even, there's studies on that. We're fucking, we're yeah, we're smart, we're the best ones.
Period. Multi-dextrous.
Yeah.
That's not even a fucking word, but you know, whatever. Who's your biggest drummer influence if you could choose? We all are influenced by lots of people. My primary, though, I would say, would be Tim Alexander.
So, okay, obviously, I want to say my dad, but I'm going to pick a famous drummer because sure. So people can hear like a real influence. But my dad is totally, dude, was the fucking GOAT. He's my favorite. By far was the best drummer. I'm going to post more clips. I got to find clips of him playing so the world can see that. But
see that, yeah.
Yeah, you got to see. Dude, he fucking was so good. Like, he made your band way better. Like, I don't care what band, any genre. He was a funk. He like played funk and he played every genre you could think, dude. He would do double bass shit. He'd fucking do jazz, like intricate fucking. But anyways, he's my guy. But like on a famous level.
Yeah.
To be honest, dude, it's like cliche, but John Bonham is like my GOAT. He's the best.
I don't think there's anything cliche about him. I mean, he basically demonstrated that you could marry tight pocket groove stuff with heavy guitar riffs. You know, Black Sabbath, obviously, yes, they did that.
Sure.
Zeppelin brought this other kind of like trippiness to their stuff.
Yeah, dude.
Sound. Like, have you heard some of the isolated tracks from that guy and some of the songs?
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah.
Holy shit, he's right. He's a fucking beast. He's so damn good. You listen to all those tunes, like Kashmir. I get chills when I listen to all those tunes.
My last pop quiz question for you is, if you were trapped on an island and could have only one of the drums from your kit for the rest of your days while you were on that island, which drum would it be?
Just one actual drum?
Yeah, it could be his tom, it could be his kick, whatever.
Okay. I'm going with my dad's snare, that Pearl Free Floater.
I had one of those.
Dude, you did?
Yeah. They're so sick, cool. Right? Dude, yeah. The snare, to me, on the drum set is by far the most musical drum on the entire thing. I mean,
I agree.
Sounds with the wires, without the wires, the range of tones you can get from the center all the way to the outside along the bearing edge and stuff, like, it just goes for cool, dude. Okay. All right, well, cool, man. I think you already plugged your website and stuff a couple times, but if there's anything else you want to share, tell people to go check out, now's a good time for that.
I want to thank you for having me on, dude. I appreciate that. This has been super cool. I love your setup and I love your page and everything you're doing, so it's super cool. And yeah, for everyone listening, thank you for listening and thanks for checking out my shit. I'm the Cowboy Drummer on everything. Thecowboydrummer.com, my band Dropout Kings, and yeah, that's all. Check it all out.